afternoon, everybody. So last week I posted up a picture on our social media of the rubber chicken that was delivered, and I know some of you are really curious as to why I have a rubber chicken. So instead of Tip Tuesday, today's going to be Teach Me Tuesday, and what I want to teach you about is our internal pressure system. So I want you to imagine that we have sort of like three balloons inside our body. So we have our lungs, which make up balloon number one. We have our abdomen that makes up balloon number two. Then we have the pelvis. So inside the pelvis, there's another cavity that makes up balloon number three. So when we take a deep breath in and expand our lungs, we're expanding the balloon. This then pushes down on the abdominals, creating pressure on the second balloon. And that pressure has to go somewhere. It can either bulge outward, so our tummy can actually bulge out, or it can put pressure on balloon number three inside the pelvis and push down. So why is this important? Well, somebody who has pelvic floor dysfunction, such as urinary incontinence, stress incontinence, or pelvic organ prolapse, specifically for women, we need to manage our pressure system inside our body. If we don't, we can have pressure push out through our abdomen, which can cause the abdomen to kind of look more full or make us appear more pregnant looking, especially if we have abdominal wall weakness, or the pressure can push down on our pelvic floor muscles. So in the case of pelvic organ prolapse, if I take a deep breath in and then I hold my breath to push down because I'm constipated, or I take a deep breath in, I hold my breath, and then I go to pick up, let's say, a semi-heavy laundry basket. I can either experience a leak, or I can also experience some symptoms related to pelvic organ prolapse. So let me kind of just show you what happens when we're not using a very good breathing technique and we're not managing our pressure system. So this is where the rubber ducky comes in. So obviously here's the rubber ducky's head. So if I hold my breath and push down as if I'm constipated, what you're gonna see is that I actually bulge out. Let me come a little closer outside of the light. So if I'm squeezing my upper abdominals, I'm holding my breath, you can see. So if you imagine this is the pelvic floor muscles, they're actually getting stretched downward. So if you have chronic constipation and you're practicing Kegels, well, the constipation and the pushing is actually counteracting the Kegels, right? Because you're creating this downward pressure that can push down on the organs inside the pelvic cavity, which can then push further into the pelvic cavity, or can put pressure on the bladder, causing leakage. So really what we need to do is make sure that when we're teaching you proper Kegels, proper lifting techniques, proper core activation, that you're actually using a good breathing technique that is helping you manage your pressure system. So by breathing is the release valve. When we exhale, we take the pressure from the lungs and we decrease it, thereby decreasing the pressure on the abdominal wall and the pelvic floor. So I hope this was helpful in explaining the pressure system, and I hope my rubber chicken demonstrates well what happens to the pelvic floor when we don't manage our pressure system. Anyways, that's it for today's video, and we'll see you next week. Bye for now.